magic. Okay.
Like this shit right here, man.
Okay.
Yeah.
About to turn this shit up.
Whoa.
Let's go.
Check it, check it out, yeah. Look, see my movements be diabolical. You be moving funny, no wonder this shit is comical. Whenever I step in the ring, I'ma do what Apollo do. By knocking your ass to the ground, you were bound for a hospital. But while you're gone, I'ma just turn your bitch to a prostitute. You could try to judge, but nigga, you never prosecute. You ain't no obstacle, you claim you stopping who? You sound illogical, time to see what Elijah do. Oh shit, now I'm that nigga singing this government. You still be the same cool nigga telling you suck a dick. It's strange how I call you Benedict Cumberbatch, but on the high ground, cause you stand on the substance. Whole team playing their role, moving so subsequent. Slowly reaching our goals, hustle with humbleness. Fucking with me, no way, you cannot fuck with this. I lyrically chop you up until you look like a puzzle, bitch. I'm in my own lane, I'm on my own level. I used to be tame, now I'm the Taz devil. I'm not you old lames, I'ma never go settle. I'ma do me, running up and get the gold medal. Whole squad for the dance, it's the renaissance. A real nigga's taking over like the scepter. I move in silence like the Pentagon and make this life worth living till I'm dead and gone. Gone, keep it running. It can't be easy.
No way.
To try to be easy.
No way.
Cause that could not be me. So what can I? How could I? What would I leave? See? So you best believe me. You better be easy.
Yo, you already know what it is, man. Shit gotta be easy. Shout out to Ayres Entertainment, and you are now tuned in to My Creator's Journey. Let's go.
What up, y'all? We are back with another Creator's Journey. It's your boy, Ez Harris. I am sitting here with Staten Island native.
Yes, sir.
My guy, Be Easy.
Be Easy.
How are you, bro? I'm
chilling, bro. You already know the vibes,
yes,
man.
Sir. Welcome cool. to the lab studios.
This shit is fucking fire.
It's lit, right? Yeah,
right. Real talk.
Hell yeah. Real it's a talk. Vibe, bro. You just did your thing in the booth. You feel me?
Of course. I always gotta do that.
That was unreleased, right?
Unreleased track. I'm going to release it. I don't know when.
Okay.
But that's the dedicated freestyle. That's what we calling that.
And like it.
Word, man, we on a mission, bro. That's all we doing, son.
You show a lot of character and like in your music and in your videos, so I like that. Like you have fun with your music.
Absolutely,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. That's all it's about, you know, having fun with this shit. You know, like shit, man, I make it look easy, feel me?
Easy.
Real talk.
So you know we gotta tap into your journey as an upcoming artist. You're definitely not new to making music at all. I looked on YouTube, I see you've been making music since 2013, 2012, like,
word.
You got videos on YouTube that say, like, 10 years ago, like,
mm-hmm.
You definitely not new to this at all, bro.
No, absolutely not. I've been doing this even longer than that, you feel me? Like, I'm 23 right now, and I've been doing this since even young, like, 8-9 years old, and, you know, the journey to be where I'm at right now, it was a long one. And the journey's still not finished, you feel me?
Facts.
But at the end of the day, I'm glad that I went through what I went through because, man, I've done stuff while I was in school, giving out free mixtapes.
Facts.
Free mixtapes for Christmas, and I had, like, 3 songs in them, and I remember seeing people put them, like, back in the desk type shit and not take it. Now, I'm an artist who could attract more than 30 people, more than 40, 50 people trying to reach the 100 mark, but like still at the end of the day I'm growing. I'm still growing as an artist. I'm still growing as a human being. Nice. Feel me?
Growing, learning, that's evolving, adapting.
Yeah, man.
It's lit.
But
that's why I wanted to highlight it, because it's like I can even hear the change in your voice, like your delivery, how you dress, everything from then to now.
Yeah,
you
know, no, absolutely. It's a brand now. Like Be Easy, you know, that's part of me, but at the end of the day, I started to realize, or I needed a lot of people to guide me and help me realize that I gotta be more than just a rapper, feel me? And I gotta, whatever part that I'm playing, I gotta dress the part. It's like a job. So Be Easy himself, you know, it's like an alter ego, but at the end of the day, you know, he's more than just a rapper. He produces. He is an entrepreneur. He has his own merch, as you see right here. You feel
shit
me?
Is fire, by
you
the
feel
way,
me, bro. Son? CTG. That's how we doing it. CTG. That's the bear right here, man.
I like that.
Stands for compelled to greatness.
I like that.
Compelled to greatness. Word. It's some fire shit.
You know
feel
you
me?
Saying?
It's some you fire. Saying? That's you it. Saying? They don't know. They don't know. But
tune in.
That's it. But at the end of the day, man, just. You know, back to the whole journey thing. Like, it's been a long one, but at the end of the day, like, it's worth it.
Definitely,
I'm finally starting to see, like the silver lining throughout all of this, mm-hmm. throughout the road, you feel me? So, yeah.
So, where did Be Easy come from, like, the name?
So, Be Easy, it's really, you know, it's a common saying that people say to each other. It could Facts. Be, you know, like, when we dap up, be like, yo, Be Easy, bro,
be easy,
you know.
Guy.
That's Facts. It, yeah, word. So, it derives from that, but also... I used to play football when I was younger. Mm-hmm. I played football for like 12 years of my life, mm-hmm. and I was always wild. I was like defense, and people would always be like, "Yo, be easy, bro. Be easy, chill before you like take his head off or whatever." You know, like I was nice, niggas. I don't give a fuck what niggas say. I was nice, but
nice
bro. But it kind of derived from that too. And plus, I'm high tempered. I have a lot of energy. And that's one of the other things, too. It's like, yo, calm down. Be easy. And I just felt like I heard that a lot throughout my life. That I'm like, fuck it. That's me.
That's dope.
That's who I'm going to be. And it took a minute for it to catch on. But, you know, as time goes by, people just only know you as what your name
what
is.
You portray
yourself. Exactly.
Facts,
I'm
facts.
Be easy. Feel me? Not Bez, not Bees. It's Be Easy. Be Easy Music, whatever. That's who I be.
Hello. Let them know,
it.
Bro.
Real talk.
So who were some of your influences, musical influences growing up?
Well, top one, I'll say, is definitely, it's my father, because he is an artist. He goes by the name of Optometrist, OPTOMETRIST. I know that whole shit
That's lit.
It's bad that I know that, but...
Nah, it's pop, so you know.
Not a word, but he was, you know... I saw his journey when I was born type shit.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, he was just getting in the groove. I saw him, and I was on stages with him at a young age when I was, like, 4, 5, maybe even younger than that. And he's at, like, a festival, and there's, like, thousands of people. And it's like, shit, I want that. I want to be this person now. But at the end of the day, he taught me. He taught me how to make my first beat. He taught me how to, you know, rap, but like write my own shit. You know, be a man with the pen and the pad type shit. Mm. You know, that's what I was doing. I got notebooks, and I'm only 23.
That's lit.
Feel me? That's where lit. I was doing shit even in like junior high school, motherfuckers just, you know, writing in notepads while teachers are teaching like. Social studies or whatever the fuck, you feel me? But worse. So he's definitely an influence. You know, he dropped Mad Project, Super Rhymes, Boombox material.
Okay.
Heated Degrees, Mad Shit, Predatory Tactics. So all of that I took an inspiration from. Now if we're talking industry wise, I'll say definitely Eminem, Jay, Nas, like those guys, 50,
legends.
Definitely legends. And then now of the new age, I'll say like Cole and Kendrick, you feel me? Even Tyler, like Tyler the Creator, that nigga, bro.
Lyrical genius.
Yeah, man. So, but yeah, those are like my.
So you listen to people who actually like make structured music and
yeah.
have delivery.
Yeah, absolutely.
Have fun, have character.
That's
like, I can
that's
see
all
that in you.
Word. That's sure. all that what it's about, really. It's like dope. Just having a persona on the microphone. Or just, you know, just being who you are.
Mm-hmm.
That's a key thing that I've always been like, you know, if you listen to any of my tracks, whether it's old or new, my shit's always about, you know, being yourself.
Right, literally.
And yeah, that's really it.
What so where did the motivation come from to be an artist? Like, cuz I know you've been dropping videos and music for years, but like
I just love it. Okay. I love doing this. You know, not to sound repetitive or not to sound like an asshole, but I really do make this shit look easy, and I love doing it.
It's dope.
I really do, and it's like nobody could do this shit that I could do, at least my way, like the way that I'm doing it. I'm still learning, though.
And you make beats, too, right?
I make beats.
What came first, though, the music or the beats?
That was hand in hand. I can't even tell you. Okay. You know what I mean? It's in my blood. Feel me? Like, that's my father's an artist. I'm an artist.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Feel me? It's just the only thing is, motherfuckers don't know about us. That's the only difference.
I was going to ask you that next, like, because I know you're from Staten Island.
Yes.
So, like, how do you feel being an artist from Staten Island, you know? Like,
yeah,
a lot of attention not really over there, but you outside. Like, you feel me?
Facts.
You in the lab right now, you feel me?
Real talk, we in the lab.
Hello. So, you doing something right. You doing something right.
You know, I'd say like this. Staten Island is it is my home. And, you know, being an artist from out there, I say that there is, not, I won't say pressure, but there is, it's a harder road because not that many people come out to Staten. Not mm-hmm. that people want to support Staten for many things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's difficult to explain, but you know what? Like I said, man, that's my home. And I'll always rock with it, but I am a New York artist.
Right.
You know, that's I'll just be like, that's why like I go outside, wherever I go, I'll take the trip to Brooklyn or the Bronx or do an event in Queens. I'll even do shit in Jersey. Like I'm just right. trying to. It's not just. I'm starting to learn now that it's bigger than just where you're from.
100%.
And there's a whole world outside.
Mm-hmm.
There's if it doesn't work here, then it's gonna work here. And if mm-hmm. one person don't like it, the next one will. Because then that's it. Like, you just got to figure. I feel like I figured that out. Or I'm still figuring out, like, that key of, like, you know, it's okay if so-and-so doesn't like my shit. Because X, Y, and Z.
Exactly.
They're going to be the same motherfuckers to bump my shit all the time. Mm-hmm. You know? And it's art. Like, that's word.
Everybody going to vibe to it.
Absolutely.
Somebody going to vibe to it. Word. Somebody going to vibe to you. You feel me?
Real shit.
Wanted to mention, I saw you in Migs videos. We had Migs here last
yes.
week.
Shout out my guy Migs, man. That motherfucker, you know what it is, nigga. I can't even talk to you or about you because you know what it is. That's my guy, though. I knew that nigga since a jit.
Yeah, it was funny. We had him here last week, and I was like, hold on. I was looking at his videos. I'm like, wait, that's Be Easy. Yeah. Oh, wow, we're going to have him here next week. I'm like,
See, there we go. See, yeah, look at outside, that. Y'all just did a whole promo with just that right. alone. You didn't even know. Feel me?
I was like, that's dope. So Staten Island's really doing their thing. So I want to make sure that I'm giving Staten Island their flowers, and I want to make sure that our platform is building awareness that there are artists out there.
Yeah, there's mad nice niggas out there.
Doing their thing, you know?
You know, the whole CTG conglomerate, feel me? Like, we moving out here, son. Shout out my nigga High C, too, bro. You know what I mean? We taking over.
Bam!
He's here. Yeah. But we take it over.
Shout out High C. He probably going to be out here next, you feel me?
Real talk.
What's the word?
What you call it? We got to talk about your projects. The first project you dropped was 2015, all platforms. And it was you didn't just drop a single, you dropped a whole project.
Nah, right? Yeah, word. So,
what's tell them the title of that?
All right, so the album, the album is called Easy Pass Fast Lane Status.
That's
now,
fire, right?
That's my baby. That's my baby. I got songs on there since I was like 12, type shit. Like,
oh, wow.
Word is a song called Realness. I think I legitimately recorded that at 12 and still released it. You know what I mean? I have your shit too. Yo, look, man.
I like that though, because like, motherfuckers some people wasn't like fucking with it.
Listen. I say it like this. Motherfuckers was not fucking with it because I dropped it in high school and that wasn't the wave in 2015.
Okay. Right.
Feel
right.
me? That's, I'll just call it what it is. And plus, my voice isn't how it is right now.
Right.
So that's another thing. You know, but then I started to realize, like, I got to just stop giving a fuck. And then that's how I dropped Vibes. Vibes. Now that one, y'all could bump that shit. Vibes. You could bump both of them. I need the money. I don't need the money, but
yo.
Vibes though. That shit. I'll talk more about that one. Cause Easy Pass, that's my baby, and I you know, that was me learning shit, produced all by me.
Yo.
You know what I mean? Still figuring shit out. Mm-hmm. Boom. I dropped a little EP. It was called like it's on SoundCloud. Y'all could find that. But Vibes, that shit, I was going through shit like I was in college, I was away.
Mm.
Still am in college, but I was in Florida.
Okay.
There was no family. Mm. Feel me? And I didn't even, like, I stopped doing music for a minute. Maybe like a year or two. Because,
that happens.
Yeah, and it was really because, you know, I didn't know what my path was.
Mm-hmm.
My path is like football and shit like that. I'm going there for sports, but, you know, that just ain't work out. But then I got the pen back, and I started making beats on this old-ass computer, man. I was using, bro, this shit. It didn't even get internet.
Mm.
Word.
Okay.
And it was a laptop. It didn't make no fucking sense.
You made it work, though.
I made it work, son. Real talk.
That's and fire, yo.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, we made... I made, like, how many tracks on that? 12 tracks. Because with the message behind Vibes is that, you know, you can even see it in the cover. It's good vibes, bad vibes, and, like, in between. Each song is like that. So it's four... Mm. It's four sets of... Oh, no, three sets of... Four sets of three.
That's dope.
Four
That's
sets
a dope
of three.
Concept.
Yeah, so, like, Sorry. Four songs would be good vibes. Four songs would be, like, bad vibes. Like, I got a song in there called What's Up With It. Now, it's a dope-ass song, but it's a bad type of... You know, it's about, like, a bitch leaving you.
Copy.
You know what I mean?
Tune in. This sounds
That's
fire,
Yo, right? listen, bro. Yeah, I got some crazy... Bro.
That's hard, bro.
That's it. Hard.
And then you dropped Major Vibes.
And like, then Major Vibes was a piggyback off of that. Shout out my guy, Major. You too, nigga. You know, I can't even talk about you without... You feel me? You know what it is. But yeah, with Major Vibes, we did, I think, 7 tracks. That one, yo, that shit was crazy because the experience alone... These both were dropped in 2019. Mm-hmm. And that experience was totally different because that's when I came back home.
Okay.
And it was like, yo, bro, it's game time. Like, let's just drop shit. Let's just drop this shit. I'm getting good love with the Vibes album. You know what I mean? People were paying attention now. I'm like, oh shit, niggas really fucking with me. Every niggas really feel like, all right, you're that nigga now. Okay,
right.
Now let's drop this shit. Be like, bomb, hold that. And it was a surprise. No marketing. Like, I'm doing this shit, spamming motherfuckers, and niggas was still bumping this shit. You feel me? Like, I'm like, you gotta figure it out.
All right.
Feel me? So, and now, soon, I'm gonna drop my next project. It's gonna be called Eyes on the Prize. EYEZ. On the Prize. And yeah, man, stay
this
tuned.
Year?
This year. Never Fold is out right now too. That's the single off of that same project.
That came out last month, right?
That came out, all right, so the song dropped on like streaming services in April 15th it dropped.
Copy.
The video dropped
Like a month ago.
Yeah. Like June.
The video's fire, by the way. Make sure y'all tune in.
Man, that fucking video.
Tell
shout out
the
my
concept
God.
Behind that real quick. Alright,
damn. What was the concept? That yo, bro, Never Fold.
Outside.
We was outside. We really was outside, though.
Outside.
We was definitely outside. Man, that shit was dope. I had the fucking BMW i8. Niggas was chilling. I had the fucking the drone shots. And yeah, we was just, you know, if you listen to my music, if and when you do, because you know my shit's fire. I talk very visual. Like, I'm a visual type of speaker or a rapper.
Right.
So even on the shit that I freestyle to or I did over here in the booth, you know, it's all, you can see exactly what I'm talking about. You can see how, you know, so I'm talking about, let me see, in Never Fold, like, there's certain lyrics that I'm doing. Like, even the step on the scene, like, I'm the Fresh Prince. I'm wearing the Fresh Prince Nike 5s, Jordan 5s. So it's like everything is hand in hand. Like,
right.
I'm wearing the right colors and shit. Like, it's just, I'm doing what my song is basically
saying.
You're making
your words coming to life.
Yeah,
like,
man.
Through the visuals. That's
Word.
Fire.
So.
Love it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Love it, bro.
Shit is fire, though. Shout out my guy X, too.
He shot the video?
Yeah.
Great job, bro.
Real
effects
talk.
Effects is dope.
Real talk.
So you said we can definitely expect an album before
yeah,
the end
some
of this
type
year.
Of project. Some type of project by the end of this year. I'm
Another
also,
video? Any more videos coming up?
I am coming up with another video. Thank you for, you know what? It's in the process. I have 2 new videos because my guy back there, he actually reminded me of one. Mm. All right, so number one, we about to do a video to our song, me and Hasi's song. What's that shit called, bro?
Feeling like the man, bro.
Feeling like the man video coming out soon. I don't know when, but it's coming out soon. Hold on, I can throw another one. Video to a song I'm doing with my boy Saint Dropper. I forgot what that song is called, but that's coming soon. We soon. That shit in Philly. We're gonna be in Philly. Stay tuned. Last one. I'm not even gonna tell you what the title is, but motherfuckers is making a Lego fucking music video.
That's gonna be
nigga
different.
Nigga. I'm not even gonna show them, but
yeah, I got
one.
Nigga. Nah, yeah, this is hard. This is hard.
You feel me, bro?
Yeah,
good shit. Bro, so coming soon to a theater near you
right.
or YouTube on your phone.
Tune in.
That's it.
Last thing I'd say, you definitely drop some gems, but like just leave your fans, your followers, family.
Yeah, absolutely.
With some motivational inspiration.
Got you. Motivational inspiration. Look, nobody perfect. You got to do what you got to do in this world. You gotta essentially just be you. And that's who I represent, and that's who you should represent, just yourself. Just be who you are. It don't matter if your shit is hot or not. Just keep striving, keep going for greatness. We are compelled to greatness, all of us. And that's it. We're gonna keep on striving. And shit, that's that.
That's the best way to put it, bro. Real talk. Nah, I definitely appreciate your time, bro.
Sure, you already know the vibe.
Just let them know where they can find you and follow you on all platforms.
Absolutely. You can find me on all platforms at B_EZMusic. That's B_EZMusic. Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, all that. Search my name up on Spotify, Apple Music as B-EZ. You're going to see my pretty, pretty, pretty face on there. And word, just hit me. You already know the vibes. I produce. I'm in school right now for audio engineering. So mixing is going to be on that shit.
He's active.
Let's work. Active. Let's go. Oh, real quick. And I'm doing acting. So there we go. Shout out to them niggas from Connecticut. Because I forgot who they were again. Because I'm smacked. But there we go. Let's get it. Yo. Shout out to Ayers Entertainment.
Gang.
You know what I mean? Stella Fam. All that shit. Santiago's Garden. Bong. Conglomerate, nigga. That's how we moving. And that's
about
some.
To, we about to smoke right now. You
Let me stop.
Bow.
All right. You ready now?